Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 2355. We don't need TEXTSPLIT. We've had it the whole time with FILTERXML. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question is from me. Hey, Microsoft, when are we finally going to get a TEXTSPLIT function like TEXTJOIN? Not just me. Look at this. 221 people have voted for this out on ExcelUserVoice.com. Turns out we don't need TEXTSPLIT. The last dueling podcast, I was trying to break this data apart, and a great comment from Daniel Dion. He says, hey, just use this formula. I'm like, what? What is this? Gorflunk? That's money. Hell yeah, that's money. This is an amazing, amazing function. Let's break this down, how FILTERXML is doing what TEXTSPLIT should do. All right, so right here, this is taking those numbers, and it is forming it into XML code. So there's an X element and then a Y element that's 1444 and Y. A Y element that's 1445 and Y. Da, 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 da. And finally, and X. How do we do this? Just starts out with X and Y in brackets. And then the substitute of this number changing every comma to a and Y, start Y. All right. And then at the end, an and Y and an and X. Now we join all of that together. So the original text here, the substitute, and the closing text. I can imagine getting to the point where I can remember this. I mean, it will take a little bit of thinking the first 10 or 20 times I do it. But eventually this would become second nature. And then the awesome thing is once we have XML, then equal filter XML, that's the XML and the X path we want is slash slash Y, close quote, close paren, and we get just the numbers split out. Now, what I really would want here is I would want them to go sideways, so I'm probably always going to wrap this in transpose like that to have it go across. But check that out, there's my transpose, filter XML. I want to be flip here and say, hey, Joe McDade, we don't need TEXTSPLIT. Although, I mean, look how much easier TEXTSPLIT would be. My vote at UserVoice still stands. Microsoft, we need TEXTSPLIT. Someday, some year, hopefully they'll get that for us. And hey, while we're talking about subscribers, here's another thing. Even for those of you who have subscribed, check out Daniel and Gorflunk. That little symbol there, that tells me that they're subscribers. But a lot of you are subscribers, and based on the default settings, I don't get to see it. You know, I don't ever want to start a membership channel where you have to pay for special features, but I appreciate the people who subscribe, although right now I know a lot of you are subscribers and I don't see that icon. In YouTube, if you come up here to your icon in the top right hand corner and then go down to settings and then inside of settings, go to privacy, right here, keep all my subscriptions private. If you turn that off, then all the people that you subscribe to will know that you're a subscriber. And they'll feel special about you. They'll feel cool that you subscribed and you're helping us to get better benefits from that 50,000 or 100,000 or 500,000 subscriber level. So it's up to you whether you want everyone to know who you subscribe to, but the creators that you've subscribed to sure will appreciate it. Well, hey, I want to thank Dion for that awesome, awesome formula, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast. MrExcel.com.